Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to transform panoramic photos into miniature 360-degree planets. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to Blue Lightning TV, click that small subscribe button at the lower right corner to let you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. For your convenience, I provided this skyline photo so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description below or project files. To get the best results, it's important that the horizon be perfectly horizontal, which we'll do in a moment, and that the sky and water be the same on both sides of our image so the edges look seamless when they meet later. First, we'll make the sky horizontal. Open your ruler tool and go to the left edge at the point where the water and the land meet. Click and drag the tool to the right edge at the same location. At the top, click Straighten Layer. Immediately, our skyline rotated to an angle that makes the horizon line horizontal. To address the empty areas surrounding our image, we can either crop them off or fill them in with Content Aware. Let's do the latter. Control-click or Command-click the thumbnail in the Layers panel to make a selection of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it by 2 pixels. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command-Shift-I. Open the Fill window by pressing Shift plus the F5 key at the top of your keyboard, or by going to Edit and Fill. Open the Contents list and click Content Aware. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Make a copy of the layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Horizontal. On the left side of the photo, we'll make a selection around the buildings. First, zoom into that area by pressing Z on your keyboard to open your zoom tool and drag your cursor over that area. Open your quick selection tool and make its radius 5 to 10 pixels. Drag your tool over the inside of the buildings to select them. To check the selection, press Q to see it as a quick mask. Revert the quick mask back into a selection by pressing Q again. To remove areas of the selection that are outside the buildings, press and hold Alt or Option as you drag over those unwanted areas. To fit the entire photo onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. We'll cut and copy the buildings that we selected by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Click Layer 1 to make it active. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Make sure your foreground and background colors are black and white respectively. If they aren't, press D on your keyboard. Open your Gradient tool and make sure the Linear Gradient icon is active. Click the Gradient bar to open the Gradient Editor and click the black and white thumbnail. Go to the left of your document and press and hold Shift as you drag across approximately this far and release. This reveals the original photo under it through the layer mask, making both sides seamless. We'll make a composite snapshot of our visible image by making the top layer active and pressing Alt-Control-Shift-E on Windows or Option-Command-Shift-E on a Mac. Open the flyout list and click Duplicate Layer. Open the document list and click New. I'll name it Duplicate Skyline. Immediately, Photoshop created a new separate document of this layer named Duplicate Skyline. Next, we'll make it into a perfect square. To do this, go to Image and Image Size. Click the chain link icon to unlink the photo's width and height. In the width field, type in the same amount as the height and click OK. Go to Edit, Transform, and Flip Vertical. Go to Filter, Distort, and Polar Coordinates. Tick Rectangular to Polar and click OK. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. If you're using version CC 2018 or earlier, go to a corner and when you see a diagonal double arrow, press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it out or in. If you're using CC 2019 or later, just press Alt or Option as you drag it. If you want to rotate it, go back to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, rotate it. To raise or lower your image, press the up or down arrow on your keyboard. Adding the Shift key moves it 10 pixels at a time. When you're happy with its size and position, press Enter or Return. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. You may see a subtle line on your image. If you do, open your Spot Healing brush. Adjust its size by making sure your Caps Lock key is off and pressing the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Make its size slightly bigger than the line you want to remove. Drag the tool over the line to heal it. Lastly, we'll punch up some of the colors. If there are specific colors that you'd like to bring out more in an image, click the Adjustment Layer icon and click Selective Color. Selective coloring allows you to cross-blend individual color channels. I generally keep relative ticked since it's far more subtle than absolute. In this particular image, I want to make the darker tones of the blues more intense, so I'll click Blues and slide the blacks all the way to the right, making the darker blue tones deeper and darker. I generally like to use the black channel, since it controls the darker tones of each of the colors, thereby making them deeper and darker, or lighter and brighter. I like to brighten the green colors, so I'll click Greens, and drag the black slider all the way to the left to brighten them. I'd like to bring out the reds more, so I'll click Reds and drag the blacks all the way to the right. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.